The DMV. The building is like hell itself. The first thing I noticed about it when I was a wee little lad was the smell. It smells like soap. I really like it. No, I don't. But I do. No! 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 But then you notice the building is kind of like a prison. It's cold. It's kind of damp. Giant inmates try and rape you. The fluorescent lights penetrate your soul. The desks are all 10 times your height, which makes all the employees look like freaking gargoyles. Speaking of 90-year-old windbags who have a week left to live, I hate the people that work at the DMV. They're all old, cranky, grouchy government employees. All they really want to do is ruin your day. I'll never forget my first visit to the DMV. Although there are like 3 entrances to that foul place, you are only allowed to use one of them. The second you get in, you are asked to take a number by one of the gargoyle employees. That number is always random. Even if you're the first one there, your number is bound to be something like 7, 234, 993, 3.141592. Why don't you just give me a 1? But then you get to sit there and wait for your number to be called. Even if you're the first one to the DMV, it still takes, no exaggeration, about half an hour before they finally serve you. So my horribly randomized number was finally called. Trembling in my little shoes, I migrated towards the gargoyle's desk. A man with white hair ambled up to the desk. He eyed me with his eagle eye. Just like that Edgar Allan Poe story. I love that story. It's gruesome, but this guy was intimidating. But he was this old guy. You could probably kill him by turning off the air conditioning. So he looks at me, and I could tell what was going on in his withered mind. Just make the kill now. He's scrawny. You can take him. You can celebrate later by going to Hooters. I love the barbecue chicken there. So we go through the whole process. Cause you know, I was getting my learner's permit. He asked for all my identification. So I hand him my information. My social security card. My student ID. My birth certificate. He looked at me ever so creepily with his wide-rimmed glasses. I can swear every moment he was with me, his permanent scowl got bigger and bigger. Doesn't he have a mommy who loves him? He was looking at my birth certificate. He nods his head no. Then he tells me I can't get my permit. He said the certificate didn't have a state or county seal on it, so he couldn't accept it as real identification. He denied it and sent me on my merry way. He didn't even say, I'm sorry. He didn't even show any remorse. The only thing he said was, next! So I went home.
Ugh!
Ugh! Oh my god!
Oh my god!
You seriously think I'm gonna lie like that, old man? You seriously think that I would bring in a fake social security card, fake student ID, fake birth certificate, and bring in a fake parent just so I could say that I'm somebody that I'm really not? Were you smoking crack? So I had to send a letter to the hospital I was born in Chicago and wait for a new birth certificate with a state or county seal on it. Last week I had another pleasant experience at the DMV. It was the big moment. I was going to take my driver's test to see if I could get my license. So I walked in, took a number, and then I waited for so long that I guarantee one of the employees went into cardiac arrest. They finally realized I had set up a frackin' appointment and brought out an old lady. She introduces herself. I introduce myself. Hey, I'm Jayla Cavalier. So I go out to the parking lot where my mom's minivan is parked. I love that van. I call it the Moonmobile. It's pretty awesome. So I did my driver's test, and I was careful as possible. But eventually I came to an intersection and was asked to make a left turn. It was one of those intersections where the left turn lane has one of those, like, red, green, and yellow arrows. Anyway, the light for me to turn left was green, so naturally, I started going. But just as I hit the intersection, there were a few people in front of me, you know? But I was already on my way, so I'm safe, right? While I was in the middle of that intersection, the light turned red. She counted it as running a red light and goes,
failure!
So she tells me,
it's okay, come back tomorrow.
By this point, I was convinced she was on some sort of hallucinogen. The DMV was closed the next day, so she was wrong. I couldn't have come back tomorrow. But anyway, the DMV is a pretty bad place. It's a lot like a retirement home, except it's only for the elderly who haven't tortured the youth of the world enough. Like me. They tortured me. Goodbye, YouTube.